class in my class. First impressions, misleading, of course. Before I begin teaching Maestro by Peter Goldoon, I ask students to tell me something they've learned from a teacher that has nothing to do with curriculum. I do this because even though you need to do well at school, you will hopefully continue to learn and continue to want to learn through the rest of your adult lives. And not only that, hopefully you realise that the caring staff at Mirrabooka offer you a lot more than formulas to do well in your exams. I came back to Mirrabooka Senior High School in 2009 after having my daughter Audrey. I remember standing in the staff room making a coffee and having a chat to Mr. Nichols, telling him about my Year 8 English class. He told me they were great. I was of a different opinion at the time. 8.1 English with this huge chatty class that I had to rearrange seating for just to pinpoint where the noise was coming from. But oh, how things have changed. I was lucky enough to take these students from Year 8 to Year 9 to Year 10, and then it got interesting. Last year I was lucky enough to adopt you as a head of year after Mr. Nichols' sad departure to another school. I did assure him though that you were in safe hands. By this time I had taught many of you in English and or media. Remember Year 10, James and Adam? You were lucky enough to see me 6 sessions a week and sometimes one session after the next. I did however repay the favour and acted in just about every one of your productions. My favourite being when I got to run James over with my car. And you can look that up on YouTube. I met these wonderful, interesting, at times crazy students and now had the opportunity to mentor them as head of year. What I didn't realise is that this would mean giving up my lunch times and sometimes half of my lunch. Dot sessions, some days after school in the homework centre, and many nights worrying if some of you would get to graduation or not. But here we are at our last assembly, and you are the guests of honour. Well done. You have grown into a bunch of exceptional human beings with wonderful hearts, and I believe the ability to bring about positive change in this world. It is with great sadness that I say goodbye to you today as a group. I've done this head of year thing before, and I promised myself I would not become so emotionally attached this time. But I did. You have made my coming to work every day so enjoyable. Whether it is directly teaching you in my class, gate crashing your form, chatting in the common room at lunchtime, or catch-ups in the hoy office. That said, I'm not sure how I'll cope next year. Who will laugh at my stupid jokes? Who will tease me about my shoes? Who will sing to me when I'm down and offer me a group hug? And don't do it now. Thank you to the English class I taught this year. You provided me with intelligent insight, great discussions, endless insight, and your own words of wisdom. Thank you to my hardworking and very obliging student counsellors, May, Rahula, Josh, Reginette, Eric and Marima, and house reps Zara and Joseph, James and Alan, Trayton and Melissa, David and Radwan, Tina and Orhan. Never be ashamed of who you are or where you're from. Your time at Mirrabooka will be remembered, whether it's for pens and paper or all of the social and sporting events you participated in. There are many things you will remember, and here are a few things I will certainly remember. I remember coaching netball when I first started at Mirrabooka and seeing May as a little kid riding on a skateboard with her mum and her brother on the neighbouring courts. I remember the day I told Josh's mum I wanted my children to grow up just like the Poxidios. I remember Bradley Booker's 15-minute monologue in Year 9 English. I remember the 10 outstandings that were awarded in Year 10 Oracy. I remember my prac teacher, Mr. Mayhew, was teaching Yasin and Ahmed how to walk into the media room and still have swag. I remember Rennie pushing me up the hill with my fractured ankle in a wheelchair at the athletics carnival last year. I remember Taz borrowing my hat at the swimming carnival, and I bought a new hat, Taz, so you can keep it. I remember Radwan telling Miss Maddie to follow the wrong car on the way to last year's graduation. And the hauler giving me shortcuts through Mirrabooka while telling me how to drive. I remember how beautiful you all looked at the ball. I remember camp, dressing up, sparklers, singing around the fire, and the very mature heart-to-heart some of us got to have. I remember dinner last night. I will never forget you, and I hope that you do keep in touch. I love you and I will miss you dearly. Thank you for being such a great year group. I take this time to please ask May and Paula to join the peers. And I'd like to leave you with something I prepared a little earlier. Thank you. Thank you.